I know already when I heard this right here, you know what I'm saying? When I heard that right there, I knew already.
Damn, Sergeant.
Y'all, you niggas is different. So what is the thing when I hear the music, I say, what is the process? Because it seemed like you reaching back and getting something from the old and kind of marrying it to the new.
Yeah, no, like this song right here, like this music, like he was playing when I was riding around with him, like he used to just drive around through the city and shit. Like I used to just ask him, like beg to just ride, like you know what I'm saying, listen to music. He used to have a system in the car, and Pop Lock and Drop It was definitely one of them songs that was playing. And
that
Intrepid or that green car you had,
the Jeep.
The Jeep. Yep.
That's how it went down.
Mm-hmm.
Man, when I heard it, I said, man, that boy got something right there, man. Hey, and it seemed
you talking about like making that beat, though?
Yeah.
Oh,
making the beat.
I'm talking about where I like got the sample. Like I reached back for the sample like back then, but like I made the beat out here.
Yeah, yeah.
Like it was me and D-Mac.
D-Mac, I talked to him night before last. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I think last night they supposed to be on Sunday.
Yeah.
So
so
how did you and D-Mac come up with that? Was y'all in college or something together?
Yeah, we was in college.
I heard about it.
Yeah.
See, I'm researching like crazy. Yeah. I want to know. So D-Mac and you, what was the process for y'all working together, and how does that work?
Oh, man, I just met him. At first, he was rapping on my beats. I met him at Digital University out here in Dallas. So, I was out there, like, with Max, I think, just up there just making beats.
Y'all done made it out, really. Yep. People knowing about you talking about going up to H-Town, pulling girls out of different situations where you can put the spotlight on them because of the work ethic that you've had and the way that people have recognized you guys already. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, Sergeant B, Sergeant J, that's a household name. Niggas knowing, they especially now. And we popping them off right here first. So when the last time y'all did an interview together? Interview.
No, we ain't never did that.
That's what I'm talking about. Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we wanted to break the mold on everything.
Yep.
Don't get it twisted. You know, I'm a little arrogant, nigga.
So you do beats too, right?
I used to.
You used to. So you just deal with straight artist development and
recording,
engineering,
mixing,
and all. So when did you switch from just being a rapper to doing all of that?
Well, from rapping, I really started with the DJing, and I started throwing parties. So I was like, well, instead of just rapping and waiting to get a show, why don't I just throw my own show?
Yeah.
And I perform at my own show. So I used to bring artists down and I would open up for them.
All in one.
Yeah. Yep. So I get the whole dough and then I just break the artists off with their little, thousand
That's
or two bands. And then we going home with 6-7. Fishing though.
Yeah.
Like, if you have a job, you're a black man with a job. Like,
yeah.
You're attracted to a lot of women, you know.
Say that's rare.
Yes. So that's something you got to deal with.
You got to deal with that. You just getting started, baby.
Oh,
man. Yeah, you locking in early, too? Yeah.
I'm good. Like, I ain't even worried
about
that.
But you seem so chill. I can't even. You a sneaky dude, ain't you?
Nah,
I think this nigga sneaky. That nigga sneaky.
I think he's sneaky.
You can predict.
That's what I'm talking about. Sergeant V ain't going to let me down. He going to tell me the truth. You sneaking around doing something. And so how did she, because DJ Juice was on here and he told me how that process went with them.
Yeah.
And I got to get through this fast, but how did the process go with you and Smitty? Did you just do it up on the caption that, hey man, Juice say we want to work with her?
I met Smitty through my brother.
Okay.
My brother was telling me I need to work with her, but I wasn't really paying attention to her because I already had like a female I was working with that I was like just really focused on. So I was like, okay, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Because he already had brought other females to me.
Okay.
So he was like, you need to work with Smith. I was like, okay, whatever. You know what I'm saying? So, like, she booked a session with me. And that's how Let Me See It came about.
Wow.
She booked a session with me because Juice told her she needed to work with me.
With you.
And my brother was telling her she needed to work with me also.
That thing happened.
Well, the Cypher, the girls, they came up with it themselves.
They came up with it.
And then they came to me to record it. And then I put the order together, you know, mixed and mastered, recorded, and had to work with all 7 of those girls.
Really? And they all from different places.
Yeah, in East Texas.
But in East Texas, but from different, you know, I'm from East Texas.
Yeah.
So Longview, kicking it with Mount Pleasant, kicking it with Paris, that's a deal. That's a stretch.
Mm-hmm.
So when I seen that, I'm like, okay, somebody had to organize this. How did they come up with putting themselves together like that? Or who picked who would be on the song?
It was those girls.
They, so it was already done when you yeah. when you
when they when came you got, to me. They was like, "We trying to do a cipher. We trying to we picking you to record it." I was like, "Okay, you know, come up, come holler at me." So they came to the studio and half like I was already working with two of the girls.
Which you working with? Which one?
I was working with Smitty and Journey. I was already recording
Smitty
them.
And Journey. But it's another one told me she coming to see you Sunday.
You talking about really the rest of the girls are coming?
No, it was the what was her name? She my cousin, actually. She hit me up. I'm like, damn, that's crazy.
But he didn't know she rap.
Man, I didn't. And I don't want to mess her name up. She was the second one, maybe? You can't remember, can you? No. Yeah, it's hard to remember. Yeah, we getting old. I'm getting
all
old.
All of them hard.
All of them was hard, but she just hit me up. Was like, and I listen to some of her music, too. Bria.
Okay.
Bria, that's my little kinfolk, man. Shout out Bria, man. I got a shout out. She did her thing, you know. I like I said, how do you work with any of them far as, because you do artist development.
Yeah.
So when you working with them in the studio and stuff, you try to give them some game on how to do this and, you know, how it can come across better?
Yes. The ones that listen.
Yeah, I know it's hard. It's hard because they think they can, hey, I got it.
Some are easy to work with. Some are hard to work with. Not those girls, because those girls, they was all good, easy to work with. But, like, it's some artists, they got the big head, so.
And you are.